Hello everyone, my name is Luis Willner and on today's video we are calculating the Gibbs energy of a chemical reaction. Consider the reaction of methane plus two atoms of chlorine react to carbon tetrachloride and four atoms of hydrogen chloride. Part A of this exercise is using the data from Appendix C calculate delta G0 at 298 Kelvin, and part B is calculate delta G at 298 Kelvin if the reaction mixture consists of 0.5 atmosphere of methane, 0.25 atmosphere of chlorine and 0.1 atmosphere of carbon tetrachloride and 0.1 atmosphere of hydrogen chloride. What we need for part A is the following equation. It says that the Gibbs energy, depending on the pressure and the temperature of the reaction, and equals the enthalpy minus the temperature multiplied with the entropy of the system or of the reaction. This is also called the Gibbs-Helmholtz equation, and it's a pretty basic and important formula for thermodynamics. We also need the Hess law, which is another important formula for thermodynamics. It says that the delta H0 of the reaction, it's the enthalpy, equals the sum of the delta H0 founding of the products minus the sum of delta H0 founding of the reactants. And what we need to use is a different version of it. It basically is the same formula but for the Gibbs free energy. For part B we need the following equation or formula. It's for calculating the Gibbs free energy on reactions that include only gases, and it's delta H0 of the reaction plus the gas constant multiplied with the temperature and the natural logarithm of the equilibrium constant K, which is from the mass law of mass action, and in this case it's gases only, so we will use the pressures. For part A, I got the data from the internet, the delta H0 foundings of the substances involved in the reaction. And here the formula that we will use, and now the data that I found on the internet, obviously. And if you're a student of Mr. Laut, you can also just get them from the Elias of the FH Aachen. Basically what you need to do is to calculate delta G0 of the reaction. You need to add up the delta G0 founding of the products, in this case it's carbon tetrachloride and four times the hydrogen chloride, minus the the delta G0 of the reactants, in this case it's methane, and two times the delta G0 founding of chloride. But as delta G0 founding of chloride is zero because they are because chloride is an atom, so it has no Gibbs free energy, and if you put in the values you get minus 395.69 kilojoule per mole. The reaction is exergonic as delta G0R is negative, which also means that this reaction has its equilibrium on side of the products. I made a small graph, as you can see. It basically just shows the energy levels of the reactants and the products, and but the difference between them is delta G0 of the reaction. For part B, what you need to know is that on reactions that include only gases, the partial pressures of each gas equals their concentration in the reaction. So in this case it's the new formula for calculating delta G on reactions that include only gases, and if I put in the values you can see that the number that comes out at the end is minus 411.61 kilojoule per mole. Yeah, then that's it already. If you have any questions, write them in the comments, maybe you can answer them. Thanks everybody for listening, and time to say goodbye.